And welcome back, gamers. This is Let's Play Colonization with your host, SKS. I'm a social studies teacher, so I know legislation like you all know perspiration. Alright, last time we were actually pretty much spying on everybody and trying to figure out what they're doing. We have a privateer down here, and we're trying to check out where the French are at and if they've expanded any. And here we found Montreal, which they settled this very, very, very far south. So they seem like they're building up a very big military force. So right now, I really don't have to worry about them at all, because they're so far south that we can actually make their cities. I can keep an eye on them from where I'm at. I can put a privateer on each one, and it's not a big deal. So at this point, I'm not going to lie to you, gamers. I'm fairly confident that I don't have to worry about them. So let's load up some more fur and some crappy cotton here and just make our merchantman go around its rounds and pick up everything we need to. I still need to get a missionary up here to this Indian place because they're starting to really, really, really get pissed off at me. And that's something that they gotta chill with that. Alright, Fort Red as we named it, and that slipped right by me. Fort Red, as we renamed it to insult the Dutch even more, is changed over to... I forgot what I was even going to say, gamers. Just pay no attention to the guy commentating on your video. You'd think of all people he would be paying attention, but for some reason, I looked at a clock in the other room, and it mesmerized me to the point where, hell, I don't even know where I'm at anymore. I don't know. We're in the new world. That's what I need to know. We're in new awesome. Awesome because we are awesome. We kicked the Dutch out of new awesome, and they went way far over. They probably discovered the Pacific Ocean, and now we're spying on the French. So, Sons of Liberty membership in Fort Red is up to 40%. Excellent. I need to go here for some reason. There was something that, yes, I needed to unload. That's what we needed. They're building, and I needed to make it to where they could actually make tools. So we're going to have to make 100 tools. We've only got 28. We have 80 cotton. Wow, I don't know why I didn't load that on the merchantman. Oh, that's right, because we took it away last time from the Dutch ship. So we'll have them sitting there trying to make 28 more tools. And we need to send more ore up there. I need to actually make wagon trains. So I need to make a wagon train. And I Hate France is now getting a +1. So we're going to zoom here and see how much extra stuff they're making. We're actually making 2 horses a turn. I don't know if we can make any more. They might not have a warehouse. But once they get this shipyard done, gamers, you'll see what I'm going to start to produce. And it's going to be something awesome. So, just stay tuned for that. That's actually working. Let's see, they're still producing tools here in New Pork. I still want to call it New Porn. I don't know why. We have tons of ore there, so that should be finished soon. And let's see what this caravel is going to do. We're going to take 50 guns with us. And I don't think anything else. Let's take 6 horses. And we will send them to spam so they can actually do things. Hopefully spam. Because here's what's going to happen. Of all the colonies that the London, the British, the English attack when we try to declare independence, watch them go straight for spam. So let's see if the British or the French here have settled anywhere else up here. I think I'm going to leave him right there and wait for that ship to come out. I will move this guy up here to this field, and we'll put a road there and expand. And let's see, there we are going to establish a mission. And the Church of Fort Boob. So far, gamers, we have the Church of Spam and the Church of Fort Boob. Excellent. Alright, let's send this privateer back to Fort Nassau and plunder on them some more. Let's see what the turn brings to us. And I believe that just went right next to me. Now, the suspicion that the French are settling up this, but like I said, they're so far away from us on the mini-map, it's like actually up a page. I'm not going to worry about them. So for once in my life, the French may not be pestering me on a video game. I know, I'm impressed as much as you are. I don't know what happened. Maybe it's just the gods of Let's Play have decided, hey, let's keep them away from him. Alright, more tools, we know this. And more tools, we're working our way up there, slowly but surely. And don't call me Shirley. So I was watching something on the internet today that was talking about the best sequels that nobody liked, and the number one movie on that was the Indiana Jones movie and the Crystal Skulls, and I'm sitting there thinking, that movie did suck. I don't care how much you can love Indy, when you throw aliens into Indiana Jones, that's terrible. Well, I guess we missed this boat. And that angers me. Let's put a road here. And let's see what this merchant man has on it. Let's serve some more cotton and more furs. And it has one more trip to make to I Hate France, and then we'll send it on its way. Alright, so my privateers have been... I'll be honest with you, gamers. In most games, when your privateers attack ships, which I knocked the Spanish out, they're one of the best countries to privateer against or pirate against because they're always carrying weapons and horses. They pretty much can... I would privateer them during my independence just to keep my army equipped because they were always at war with the Indians. Alright, Spam has actually produced something. I am impressed. So docks will be next. We're going to move this guy out here, though, to produce some food. Actually, I might put him outside to be a pioneer. And we'll have him... Well, there's really nothing for him to plow and make. So I guess I'll put him back to work making docks so we can fish. Alright, they're still making tools there. They keep reminding me of that. Let's see, maybe we can buy this. 200 loads. Let's see how much this will cost. 98. We will go ahead and complete that. And... let me see. Did I need to work on anything? We'll let them build that fort. Our cargo of horses and guns head to Spam. And my game has frozen. Oh, we have discovered the Pacific Ocean. How about that, gamers? There's the dude's horse right there, and he's just like, huh, how about that? Sometimes I always wonder, though, how do they know it's the Pacific Ocean? All right. I didn't know if we would actually discover that in this game or not, but we have done pretty good. So let's go down here and work on the French some and steal some of their goods, because they've not expanded a lot like we have, but I'm sure they got some items coming in and out that we can pirate on and make money. Because we're kind of low on funds right now. I'd kind of like about 5k going into any war or anything like that. And obviously they have a couple of merchantmen, so they have money to buy these. So we'll just have to see how that goes. And there's a couple places up there I'd like to explore with my scout. And let's zoom to this colony and see how much would it cost to buy the tools. I'm not going to spend two-thirds of my money on that. So they're just going to have to do the best they can and make some more tools. Alright, Sons of Liberty up to 40%. A new cargo of ore. So we'll let them keep making ore, and that's probably the place where we need to ship ore north. That's why I pretty much need a wagon train. So we might make that here at New Fork. Alright, we have a fort. Let's make a wagon train. Put these guys back to work here. What can I have this guy? Let's have him do his 12 ore. And we'll get busy with that. Alright, things are looking up now. I still wish some colonists or some Indians would convert over here. Let's see, I want to settle north. Or not settle, but search so we can get more map and figure out what's going on over there. Alright, here's Montreal, so we're going to stay right here and wait for ships. Same thing there. Alright. Let's load up this merchantman with some other things that we want to sell. Junk, crap like that. And we will send them back to... I hit the fortify button. I'm an idiot, folks. I was like, why didn't he move? Let's clear orders. Probably still lost that turn. And we will sit right here and wait for another ship to come into Fort Nassau. So we can mess with the Dutch some more. Sorry, my Dutch viewers, you'll just have to deal with it. Look at all those resources out there, folks, and we can't get to any of them. Alright. Normally, I'd pay attention to these prices if I was really into the trade game, but I'm not. I'm more for, let's set our goal. We want to be on our own eventually, so I'm not going to pay attention. Let's see, how much does this cost? $3.92. I'm hoping that after he makes these next four that the price will drop a lot because he'll have almost half. Sometimes, I know there's a way to figure that out, but I'm not really going to deal with it. Alright. And we have met the Arawak. I'm actually glad we didn't end up near them because they will attack you early on. For some reason, they just randomly raid you for stuff. But yes, we will act like we're going to care about you. And we will sit here off the coast and wait here. And who has the most tools? Pretty sure that one of these places is making tools. Yes, we'll send him down to... I don't think it was Fort Boob, but we'll just keep sending him south until we can load him up with some tools. Alright, now I know some more things have been made, so we'll load that. And send you back to the old world. Say hello to London for me. Alright, so our privateers are in position to pick on both countries. Oh, and... he slipped right by me. So I feel really dumb now because I positioned that totally stupid. Because I thought there was one coming out of harbor, but honestly there was one coming in harbor. So, I probably just lost a lot of goods, like guns and things like that. Alright, so I know they're out of ore here. We'll have you making hammers, and we'll go ahead and complete it because we're going to be making money here soon. I Hate France is up to 60%, so people are getting tired of the king. Though he's not really been mean right here lately, so I don't really know what their beef with him is. Alright, so let's unload guns and these horses. We'll take your silver and your furs. And that will be all we need. And then back to the scout. We'll go speak with your chief, expert oil miners, and $304. So see, we paid for our thing right there by just visiting. Alright, so we'll put them right here to block that, and I still want him to come out of port, so I don't need to block it now. I would love for them to bring some more silver out of Fort Nassau, so that way I could plunder it. Oh, stop, 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 stop. Ooh, it might still be there, gamers, or might not. They might be in the perfect location where they have just enough moves to outrun me. And here comes the Dutch. Howdy, howdy. Fort Boob, 6 cotton. As the Indian music plays, they're probably ready to attack me. Alright, Fort Red has upgraded to an actual fort. And I think we will build a church here. Let's move a few things around a little bit. Alright, we'll leave it like that. Tools for the shipyard. We definitely need to go there and change that stuff around. They only have 7 ore. But he can start doing ore there, but we'll have this guy help make... Let's actually make him make crosses so we can get more population over. And we are reaching the end of this episode, so gamers, join me next time when hopefully we'll do something exciting, because I did this entire episode while sitting on the toilet. So join me next time, gamers. This is SKS, signing out.